Good afternoon, everyone. Once again, we're glad to have you here at the Bluegrass Now stage. They are IBMA award nominees and also are sponsored by Odom's Tennessee Pride Country Sausage. Please welcome from Knoxville, Tennessee, CMH recording artist Pine Mountain Railroad.
Such a sight. Gun to grind, find out the railroad. And smoking out his paradise. Silver Dollar City today. Is this your first trip here? Raise your hand and let us know if it is. Well, I hope that everybody's been as helpful and happy and welcoming to you as they have been to each and every one of us. And I know you'll be back many times, just like the rest of these folks here. You've already had some great family entertainment this morning, some of the very best in the United States. And we get to see them as we travel around the country with them. Sometimes we're going counterclockwise to them, and sometimes it's exactly in sync with where they are. But it's always good to see the Cherry Holmes family. And today, Pine Mountain Railroad's going to bring to you our brand of bluegrass music from the hills of East Tennessee, right out here in the hills of Missouri. We're going to step back in time a little bit with some of our very favorites right here. Flatten Scruggs and I'll go stepping too.
Right. is your glibbing headed to me. All the 49 boys are glad to be up this way for a program. Right now we're going to get a North Carolina boy around the old five-string banjo. Deliver you a tune. Those of you not familiar with the state of North Carolina, right here is living proof they can raise whatever they want to down there. Here, if you will, the 49 breakdown.
Stick, and he's mighty hard to miss, but in case you have missed him, he looks awful dapper down there today. He's all rested and ready to fiddle up today. I think you can tell by that right now. He's spent a large amount of time with a lot of the greatest bluegrass bands in the world and some of the finest country acts in the world. You probably would know all of them if I called all their names, but we don't have time. I'll just say this. He's a former bluegrass boy from back in the days with Bill Monroe. Please welcome Mr. Michael Fagan. Standing here just tearing this old hound dog up off of good. He studied and picked with Uncle Josh Graves and also with the great Gene Wooten, and he comes to us mighty seasoned for his age. We're glad to have him. He's from Bardstown, Kentucky. Please say hi to Mr. Matt Despain. Yeah. Back here second lead, and you're going to hear some of his original songs coming up soon. He's from over in the East Tennessee area. We've known him a long time, and we have to go on the words of the King of Bluegrass who picked and sang with him, and he said he's a good one. That's plenty enough for us. Please say hi to the very good one himself, Mr. Jerry Butler. Yeah. Ever been a man, he sure can do what he needs to. With that there varnish model F5 Gibson that his papa got for him over in North Carolina. He's a graduate of the Maggie Valley University of Bluegrass, having spent 4 years with Professor Raymond Fairchild. And we're glad to have him as part of Pine Mountain Railroad. Please say howdy to Mr. Cody Schuler. Here beside me began this band about 6 years ago, actually now just over 6 years ago. He's from originally down in Orlando, Florida. He makes his home up in Knoxville, Tennessee. Now he's sponsored by Gibson Acoustic Instruments. Gives you some idea of what they think of his talent on the banjo. We're glad to have him today, and I'm going to tell you about a song we're going to do. But this man right here is Mr. Kipper Stitt.
Well, he's doing all the talking for us this afternoon. Does a mighty fine job with the bass. He also has a title, folks, not just Mr. or Sir. We refer to him as our bus operations manager. What that means is, it's boot camp when we hit the first step and all the way into the back of the bus.
I think the Cherry Homes know all about that.
Yes, sir. I'm sure they do.
I'm sure it's not as bad as ours. Just
it couldn't be any worse than ours. No, no way. He makes his home in Knoxville, Tennessee. Every band has to have a father figure. Bill is our grandfather figure.
Hey, watch it.
Watch it, yes. He's also an ex-federal agent. So if you got anybody you need checked out, you got a list of people and fingerprints you want analyzed or anything, handwriting you want analyzed, anything like that, background checks, he's good for that too. He claims that we were all paroled into his custody when he retired from the agency. Some people get a pension, he gets five musicians. Say hello, Knoxville, Tennessee's Bill McBean.
Yeah! Thank you. I just want to say one quick word about that grandfather thing. I am not as young as I look, I'll have to admit that. All right, this song right here that we're going to do is going to be on our next project with CMH Records. We think it's going to be a feature tune. We'll let you be the final judge of that. Please come by our record table. It's back over your right shoulder. Give us your ideas, your thoughts about this song right here. We think it's a mighty fine one. Like all good bluegrass ballads, it's a true story. It deals with tragedy, but it has hope and promise. It's written by our banjo player, Mr. Kipper Stitt, and we think it's a beautiful song. I hope you like it. It is called Laura Jean.
My dreams, my
Why do we even make these out?
I don't know why we even make those things out. It must be, you know, speaking about the grandfather figure, they say.
Bus operations
does not mean he makes out the set list.
I made it out of the bus.
Well, there you go.
Oh, boy. He got those new glasses and can't do a thing with them. We're going to do a gospel tune for you now that I wrote this tune just sitting on the front porch one afternoon, piddling around with some chords. And the song came to me, and we hope you all enjoy this tune. I simply ask, will you have wings to fly away?
Way.
good to hear a moonshine song right in the middle of a gospel set, is it?
Keep it balanced.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking Kipper makes out the next set. He went to the pharmacy to get him some of them pills, you know, that help you remember things. Problem is, he can't remember to take them. Here we go.
Now what, he says. We really didn't mean to do that earlier, folks.
Throwing that other song in there. Sometimes things happen like that.
We enjoy doing gospel music. We're not a full-time gospel bluegrass band. We are a full-time bunch of Christians that enjoy playing gospel music. We know that without a talent given to us from up above, we wouldn't be able to stand up here in front of the crowd like you folks and do what we do and pick and sing and have a good time at it. So gospel music is just a way of paying back credit where credit is due. We're going to do one more for you now. Y'all know the words to this one if you've heard it somewhere along the line. Well, sing along with us, and if you don't know the words, well, just follow the bouncing Adam's apple. That'll work too. Yes, sir. Come right in. Just throw that out to the audience as a souvenir. There you go.
Okay. We're ready.
To call the old country church.
Song's been heard down through the years by just about everybody that ever listened to country and bluegrass music. It's heard now every Saturday night, and 2.5 years ago, we were honored with getting to record this bluegrass style. But I want you to do what we do every time you go to this door. Take home a pound or two of Tennessee Pride.